I give the floor to Lieutenant Maria-Christina GIANNAKOPOULOU to present a very important topic, available beds in the intensive care units, a very tough decision that hopefully we will not have to encounter. The floor is yours.
Thank you very much. Good evening to all of you, dear majors, ladies and gentlemen. Well, as Chairman said, hopefully we are not in the dilemma how we are going to use our beds here in Greece, but this is a very tough allocation to do if we need so. Catastrophic events, as we know, can destruct the healthcare system and trigger the need for medical triage in order to effectively prioritize care and to do the greatest good for the greatest number of victims. As we know, triage is a term borrowed from the battlefields of war, usually involves attempting to select those patients who are most in need of immediate medical care in order to survive. It's the process of screening, evaluating, and sorting patients based on their medical status and likely outcome. And triage may occur at the site of a disaster, in the pre-hospital setting, in the emergency department, in the patient or outpatient acute care setting, and it is categorized as below. As you can see, the last category involves assessment of the value of ongoing resource commitment during delivery of definitive care. And for example, deciding about continued ventilator support, which is something that unfortunately some countries have to do in order to control the pandemic patients. So in a cross-sectional study, which conducted in 2015 to investigate the reverse triage is a system of reviewing the acuity and needs for current patients when a catastrophic disaster occurs and determining which patient may be safely triaged for early discharge from healthcare institutions in order to minimize the damage, to control the situation, and to improve hospital response and capacity. And the meaning of reverse triage in a cross-sectional study conducted in 2015, they investigate reverse triage to create additional hospitality, and the result shows that running reverse triage in 41 wards and units of the hospital added 108 beds to the hospital capacity, which is very useful in such situations. The COVID-19 epidemic revealed the vulnerability of healthcare systems and how they can rapidly be overloaded in excess of the available ICU bed and ventilator capacity. So this led to critical care resources being rationed in countries such as Italy, at times based on arbitrary age cutoffs. Healthcare demands triggering the implementation of triage protocols to determine ventilator allocation, and subsequently score-based rationing protocols were proposed to allocate intensive care unit ICU bed swiftly and in a consistent manner. Those predictive models are to support healthcare authorities in early planning of resources, personnel, ICU and hospital bed capacity. And early estimation of the existing hospital and ICU capacity are partial for reduction of complete cancellation or non-emergency services and surgery and non-urgent admissions. The selection seeks to identify those patients unlikely to survive, and these patients are then cared for differently, treated symptomatically and compassionately in anticipation of their death. ICU bed availability is particularly challenging in older people because those who are most likely to require critical care but for whom benefits are most uncertain. Before applying score-based triage, physicians must discern if older people will benefit from critical care and if these older people want to have critical care. Decision must be based on individualized risk stratification that encompasses evidence-based predictions of adverse outcomes specific to older adults, and also truthfully convey the emerging clinical reality. Survival will also need to be weighed against burden of treatment, as well as longer-term functional defeats and quality of life. As you can see, current epidemiological evidence shows poor outcomes, particularly for the oldest ones, and physicians advocating for their patients' best interest must discern the subgroup of older people who may survive if offered critical care. To do so, clinicians will need accurate prognostic tools. Unfortunately, none of the COVID-19 triage protocols had underwent scientific validation. The first ICU triage protocol for use following the SARS epidemic back in 2003, was the SOFA score. SOFA score originally is a sepsis score, is a very simple and required limited laboratory data to calculate it. Following the 2009 pandemic, where ICU triage was not required as resources were not overwhelmed, the performance of the SOFA score was predicting outcomes in critically ill patients was evaluated by multiple research projects. And one of them was about comparison of hospitalized patients with ARDS caused by COVID-19 or H1N1 pandemic. The results show that median SOFA scores and on admission for COVID-19 was lower than the other one that patients, and the protocols are not helpful for triage during COVID-19 pandemic, because the majority of published triage protocols use a SOFA score which is lower to identify the highest priority group, and with admission of SOFA scores for both survivors and non-survivors being typically lower than the threshold. So it's still very difficult to have for the ICU patients. And another one, another study about development of reverse triage system based on modified SOFA score for increasing care of surge capacity shows that scores can contribute to the design a leveling system for discharging patients from ICU. Based on this system, the members of the caring team can predict the final health status of the patient. So, as we go on, humanistic issues magnified by this crisis, such as those concerning perceived burden of treatment, and the timing of implementation of each measure should balance the dual imperatives of minimizing the potential harms related to implementing such measures and implementing the measures in a timely enough fashion that they accomplish the goal of maximizing overall benefit. The myth of the myth that those dying are old and depend in slowly being dismantled, as we realize that the truly awful disease this is. Perhaps the cruelest element of the COVID-19 disease is that patients admitted to ICU receive no visitors, and they will only be surrounded by caring staff when they die. If the number of COVID-19 cases is such that capacity is overwhelmed, the prospect of triage is a real one, and this is a completely new ethical arena. These are extraordinary concepts for extraordinary times, and those who have argued that doctors make this decision all the time are wrong. The decision is about individuals, and when triage occurs, the decision are about what is in the greater good, doing the best for the most and the best for society. COVID-19, as you know, is here to stay, and this conversation aims at achieving gold cordon care that must become a new clinical norm. In Greece, in our country, until now, we didn't face this dilemma, and the COVID case clinics were established, and appropriate facilities, materials, and means were provided for the high level of provision of health services to the personnel of our country and their families, as well as the provision of beds to the wider society. Military hospitals have now 35 single beds and 18 ICU beds that are available to the Ministry of Health in order to cover general cases of National Emergency Center. And as Hippocrates once said, wherever the art of medicine is loved, there is also a love of humanity. And we hope that we will always be able to do the best for the higher number of people. Thank you very much. And I have available also the bibliography for this presentation. Thank you very much.
Sir, your mic is off.
Excuse me. Okay, sorry, sir. Thank you for this presentation, very informative. We hope that we will not encounter this dilemma and we will not need to use this kind of algorithms, but we have to know them and study the issue in order to achieve the best result. Now, we are moving on to the last presentation. This is a presentation that left it on purpose for last because we are going to prepare this presentation. Elisabetta, please, you may ask questions later, please, if you are so kind.